Airtable is at it again, dropping a brand new feature, and this one's been in the works for at least a year. It's been a long time since I first remember hearing about this. I'm talking about the Quickstart for Airtable apps. Did you know that now, with this new feature, you can build your own app with just a few clicks and have all of these template components put into your system? I'm going to be exploring this new feature, the Quickstart apps, currently in beta. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we help you to get organized and automated with no code. Airtable is one of our favorite no code tools, and so I am really excited to check out this brand new feature. I have not tried it myself, and so I'm going to be giving you my real initial thoughts on this very feature as I go through it myself for the very first time. Now, before I get into that, I first want to invite you to join me for some training. If you're new to Airtable, you are going to want to master the fundamental components of Airtable, all those key features, and I outline all of them in my free Airtable Crash Course. Grab the Crash Course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll include links wherever you found this video. Without further ado, though, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and take a look at our first Quick Start app. Now, in order to access this, you're going to need to build a brand new anything in Airtable from scratch. So here I am on my Airtable dashboard, and in the bottom left corner, I'm going to hover down here and create something new. And you see that I've got my new little feature here, App Quick Start. Now, apparently, this is going to allow me to walk through some different steps, telling it what it is I'm trying to build. And then I don't know if it's using AI or through using some templates and something from like a more algorithmic approach. But apparently, Airtable is going to create the app for me based on how I answer these different questions. So let's see. Is it any good? Is it up to what it says it is? Let's check it out. So I'm going to do a quick start. And it's going to tell me to select a workspace. I overlooked that. Let's go ahead and drop this into my Gap Consulting workspace. And again, I'm going to click on Quick Start. Okay, so it's asking me what kind of app I need, and it's broken it down into five major key categories: marketing and creative, product development, project management, IT and support, and UX research. I feel like a lot of the apps that we're called upon to build all seem to fluctuate around either project management or marketing and creative, but I like that they've included some other options here as well. I'm sure these are the five strongest use cases that they've seen most people building inside of Airtable. Maybe over time they're going to add more here, I don't know, but I'm going to go with project management for our little application. Now, this is interesting. Right now, I've got like a preview of the app over here. It's saying it's untitled, but it's telling me that I can pick up to five, different components here for this app. Looks like I can also switch this around. If I wanted to go back to product development or maybe IT and support, I can flip through the different types and select different components. So with this, I could add employee equipment to IT and support. I could also add IT support tickets, office equipment. If I wanted to flip into other ones, I could start adding other components like budget and OKRs. That's really interesting. I'm curious to see how all these components work together, because what makes Airtable powerful is how it links data on the back end. So is this smart enough to start linking all my tables appropriately, or is this just window dressing? You know, is this another nice to have feature that really doesn't serve any true purpose? We'll see. All right, so here I am. I'm back in my project management. I've selected OKRs and budget. Let's go projects and tasks. And I will add programs. So I've got five selected here, and now I go next. Now, again, as I see over here, it's showing me the application, and it looks like this is an interface. It's giving me a sneak peek at what my Airtable interface is gonna look like. So I'm gonna click next and see where it takes me. It's now saying choose app workflow templates. So enhance the app with bundles of Airtable functionality. That's super interesting. So I really like this concept because I'm able to essentially talk about streamlining workflows right out of the gate. And so now that I've chosen the different components of my particular app, it's saying, you know, add these different workflows. So let's just add them all to see what it is. This one is going to send a scheduled digest on Monday. It's going to be a summary of any updates, and I can add it to OKRs or projects or programs. That's interesting. Let's add it to projects and see what that looks like. Next, I have a collect status updates. This is going to get status updates from project owners at a regular cadence. That's interesting. Let's add that as well. And then lastly, I have this track and assign tasks, manage tasks for your projects and see their status. That sounds right. I mean, I definitely want to track and assign tasks. Looks like it's already been added here to tasks, so I'll include that. I also see on the right-hand side, before moving on, it's saying that included with this, it's going to include an automation and a table. So I'm really interested to see how this all ties in again on the back end. You know, when we build things from scratch in Airtable, we always start with planning the workflow first, and then we build a data schema. And then lastly, we start layering on the automations and the interfaces. So I'm interested to know, is it taking the same approach or are things a little different here? Let's click next. Now it's going to ask us, do we have any existing data that we want to import? I'm going to say no, I'll just skip this. And lastly, I will get to name the app. So I'll say project management example from app builder. And I can pick my color, give a little bit of a customization here, right? Choose an icon. I'm good with the rocket ship. And I'll say finish. So it's going to create that app now. And again, I'm most excited while Airtable is thinking, I want to go into that back end and figure out, did it link all my stuff together? What does it look like? Is it making sense, you know, from a structure standpoint? But it's pretty cool that, I mean, just like that, I was able to create this app. And I have all of this fake data, obviously, starting in here. But again, as much as I love interfaces for the day-to-day work and for how we deploy an app, that's not going to help me understand the data schema. I need to go into the back end. So I need to see the data, and I'm going to open that up in a new window and flip on into the data schema. So what I'm seeing first is it's saying, hey, you can import data here or manage the settings from the table drop-down menu. Super interesting. I can hide the table, manage fields. Wow, lots of opportunity here. This is pretty cool. Obviously, I can reorganize this, and I do see that not only did it create the tables, it also interlinked the tables. So I'm looking at my budget table here, and I see that I have links to programs and categories and expense line items. Now, if I were to drill into programs, I have programs here. They've been named certain program managers. They have different status here. And again, those are linking to projects and tasks and budgets. I guess what I'm really looking for is to see, does the linking make sense? So let's actually go to our extensions here. And what I want to look at is my data schema extension. If you didn't already know, you can add the data schema extension. It is an Airtable extension. And by adding it, it's going to allow us to better visualize how all of these different tables interrelate in our database. So I'm going to drag these different pieces out so that I have an idea of what I'm working with here. So it looks like budgets is tying to a couple different things. I see a link to categories, and I'm seeing a link to what looks like expense line items. Let me zoom out here a little bit more and see if I can't drag stuff around. Oh, we're also connecting to programs. So, I mean, obviously budgets are a core component of this. I also see my key results. I see my projects tying to project updates. What do quarters tie to? They tie to objectives. So it's like my OKRs and my quarters are kind of related. My projects here relate to tasks, as we can see, as well as programs. And my programs are also tying to tasks. And my key results and my project updates. Okay, so there's a lot going on in this app. And so just at first glance, I'm impressed that Airtable was able to build how many different tables. I mean, this is 10 different tables just from me selecting a few options from dropdowns and properly associating those tables together. That's pretty powerful stuff. But the million-dollar question that I'm still stuck asking is this capable of actually being a ready-to-deploy app? Am I really able to just go in and make a few selections like that? I don't know that I'm fully convinced that we're there just yet. Because here I'm going back to the interface here. This is what first loaded when we set this up. And I don't necessarily know that I'm yet buying into the idea that this is ready to deploy. I feel like I, number one, have to definitely spend a lot of time familiarizing myself with what just got built for me. So the double-edged sword here is, if I'm building something from scratch, then I know exactly what I'm building, and I'm only building what I need. And my gut tells me that if we're going to use templates like this, while it might get us stood up very quickly, we probably have a lot of extra noise that we don't need for our particular use case. And my other concern here is that by just implementing something like this, we don't do the due diligence as builders to make sure that we really understand our process. So is this going to really change the game? Honestly, I'm really curious to know what your thoughts and opinions are. I'm really excited about anybody who can get up and running in Airtable more quickly. But if that person doesn't fully understand what it is that they're doing with the tool, then my gut feeling is that, frankly, they're not going to be a sticky Airtable user. In my experience, and yes, I'll be the first to admit that obviously it is somewhat limited. I haven't worked on every single Airtable project out there. I don't know how all of their target customers think. But my personal experience in the implementations that I've done is that if people don't understand what it is they have created, then they're not going to use it. And if they don't use it, then they're not sticky Airtable customers. And so on one hand, I think this is pretty fancy and pretty cool. On the other hand, though, I have some questions and I have some what I would consider healthy skepticism around this new feature. But I want to hear from you. You watching this video, what do you think? Are you going to use this and implement a lot of new, amazing operations, workflows in your organization? Or is this just kind of a coolish feature that you probably won't ever use? I'd love to hear from you. Let me know what questions or comments you have below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.